Welcome to IAS Kannada Vahini. That is, we are continuing with the IAS 2020 preliminary examination question analysis. Today's question is, different judicial mechanisms applied to recover the NPA by commercial banks in general. In this regard, note the following. There are four facts given: administrative tribunals, Lok Adalats, Debt Recovery Tribunals, Surface Act. So these are the four things are there. Which of the above are directly related to recovery of NPA of scheduled commercial banks? So here, that is 3 and 4 are the answer. That is B is the answer. Debt Recovery Tribunals and Surface Act. Then coming to the fundamentals of this question, what is NPA? NPA full form is non-performing asset, means the loans which are lent by commercial banks to the customers, if they become non-recoverable, then it is called NPA. That some time period is fixed, like 90 days, etc. The person who has taken the loan, who has not paid within 90 days and he has not kept his account, that is loan account, regular, then that account is called NPA. So it has become a huge problem, that is in the banking circle in 2011 and 12 or 2013 and 14. So that is what we call like NPA. That NPA is highest in State Bank of India. Then coming to the question, administrative tribunals are the institutions, judicial institutions which deal with the administrative aspects of an employee, maybe public sector or government employee, etc. Then Lok Adalats are the, you can say like the judicial institutions which deal with the local issues. Whereas the debt recovery tribunals are mainly meant for recovering the debt. Suppose like some debt crisis is there or debt is to be recovered, then one will go to the debt recovery tribunals. Then Surface Act wise, the full form of the Surface Act is securitization and reconstruction of financial assets and enforcement of Security Interest Act 2002. So this act has been enacted during India government headed by Atal Bihari Vajpayee. So under this act, the banks can issue the notice to the defaulter and recover the loans within, you can say like, say 3 months or 2 months or 1 month, etc., including like physical assets. So it was a very strong act. Initially very strong act, now it has been diluted. Anyway, there is a different mechanism today to recover the loans. So these are the two institutions which are directly deal with the recovery of debts, that is debt recovery tribunals as well as Surface Act. Then I have already explained the NPA, what do you mean by NPA. Then debt crisis is one of the stumbling block of the expansion of the banks as well as their financial health. So for this, the government or the, you can select the Reserve Bank of India has brought the Basel norms. What do you mean by Basel norms? I think all of you may be knowing. It is a small city in Switzerland where like all the European bankers gathered together and they have framed some rules for banking institutions. So whenever the banks face some extraordinary situation or risk, whether they are capable of coming over the or overcome the that kind of risk, that is the issue. So Basel norms are mainly for, you can say like, the testing the financial health of the banks. So now from April 2019 onwards, all the banks in India are also applying the Basel 3 norms. There are different setups of banks, I mean norms, Basel 1, Basel 2 and Basel 3. Now Basel 3 is implemented. So this is how like the Basel norms are actually measuring or gauging the capital adequacy ratio, that is in each commercial bank. Well, in simple terms, one can say like whether they have got the proper balance between asset and liability. Okay, this is the, you can say like kind of NPA and the recovery of NPA in the financial sector.